This is such a refreshing change where you have a president in an administration that is engaging with business.
We have a president who's very eager to roll back regulations. He wants tax reform, he wants infrastructure. Can Washington catch up to this Trump administration?
Washington can't slow him down. Washington has to catch up. It's no different than business. When you go into a company that has some challenges, you have to be aggressive without breaking the business, without breaking the culture, but you have to pull that along. You can't let them pull you back. And change will be the only constant we're gonna see over the
you
next 4
so?
Years. Yeah.
What kind of leader is he? And he doesn't govern like a president. Does he govern like a CEO?
In my 40 some years in management, I've always said your priority list can't be vertical. It has to be horizontal. And you have to do things concurrently, not sequential, if you want to get them done efficiently,
right,
effectively, and on time. So I think he's really leading like a CEO. It's his background, it's what he's done. It's his comfort zone, and he has to grow into being presidential.
CEOs don't want the government picking winners and losers. Yet then I hear this Republican president, business guy in the White House, calling out companies and congratulating some companies. That's a really remarkable change from the Oval Office.
I would look at it from the standpoint of he's really trying to encourage other corporations to step forward. And he's trying to create, I think, that collegiate competitiveness. He's picking out these companies that are stepping forward and using them as role models and hoping other corporations will step forward.
So you're not concerned about him calling out companies, in tweets and stuff?
No, I think as long as it's not, trying to manipulate the stock market or the stock price, I think if it's done in a constructive way about making sure we keep jobs in the U.S. that should be in the U.S., I think it'd be okay.
Let me ask you about Steven Mnuchin, the new Treasury Secretary.
Yes.
He has said he hopes to have a tax reform package by the August recess.
Yes.
You think it's possible?
Whether it's possible or not, they have to. I think a lot of the growth in the market is based upon some type of reduction in corporate tax. I think it's based upon some formula for repatriation. We can't wait too long because I think it will dampen the spirit of what people think are coming with the excitement in job creation and reinvestment.
Will repatriating money at lower tax rates translate into new American jobs? In 2004, I think, we had a similar kind of a short-term repatriation bill, and I don't think any jobs were created. It went right into share buybacks and investors.
Right. That's a bad thing. So, one of the thoughts about this is let's take 25% of the money that comes back and put it into the infrastructure fund, point one. Point two, you bring the CEOs individually, look at their income statements, what are they doing on the balance sheet, and then you hold them accountable with reviews. But I agree that we shouldn't just let it come back and just go to stock rebuybacks.
That'll hurt the whole mission of the Trump administration in some of these Rust Belt places and some of these coal towns. He says he's going to bring jobs back.
And he must. His campaign was based upon trying to recognize, as he called it, the forgotten man or woman that's out there. I think if we can do that, it raises the whole country.